Daily evening prayer. Saturday, April 6th, 2024. Thanks be to God, who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Let us humbly confess our sins to Almighty God. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from your ways at Lordship. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against your holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done, and we have done those things which we ought not to have done. And apart from your grace, there is no hope in us. O Lord, have mercy upon us. Spare all those who confess their faults. Restore all those who are penitent, according to your promises to them, to all people. Christ Jesus, our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for us, that we may now live a godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Grant your faithful people, merciful Lord, pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins, and serve you with a quiet mind, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Lord's name be praised. O gladsome light, pure brightness of the ever-living Father in heaven, O Jesus Christ, holy and blessed, now as we come to the setting of the sun, and our eyes behold the vesper light, we sing your praises, O God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. You are worthy at all times to be praised by happy voices, O Son of God, O Giver of life, and to be glorified through all the worlds. Blessed is the one whose unrighteousness is forgiven and whose sin is covered. Blessed is the one to whom the Lord imputes no sin and whose spirit there is no guile. But while I held my tongue, my bones wasted away. I ceased not from groaning all the day long. For your hand was heavy upon me day and night, and I was dried up and withered as in the drought of summer. Then I acknowledged my sin unto you. I did not hide my iniquity. I said, I will confess my sins unto the Lord. And so you forgave the wickedness of my sin. For this reason shall all the godly make their prayers unto you at a time when you may be found. When the great floodwaters rise, they shall not reach them. You are my hiding place. You shall preserve me from trouble. You shall encompass me with songs of deliverance. I will instruct you and teach you in the way that you should go, and I will guide you with my eye. Do not be like the horse and mule, which have no understanding, whose mouths must be held with bit and bridle, or else they will not come near you. Great troubles remain before the ungodly, but mercy embraces those who trust in the Lord. Be glad, O you righteous, and rejoice in the Lord, and be joyful, all who are true of heart. Rejoice in the Lord, all you righteous. It is fitting for the just to be thankful. Praise the Lord with the harp. Sing praises unto him with the ten-stringed lute. Sing unto him a new song. Make skillful melody, and cry aloud with joy. For the word of the Lord is true, and all his works are faithful. He loves righteousness and true judgment. The earth is full of the goodness of the Lord. By the word of the Lord, there were the heavens made, and all the hosts of them by the breath of his mouth. He gathers the waters of the sea together as in a heap, and lays up the deep as in a treasure house. Let all the earth fear the Lord. Stand in awe of him, all you that dwell in the world. For he spoke and it was done. He commanded and it stood fast. The Lord brings the counsel of the nations to naught. He makes the devices of the peoples to be of no effect, and casts out the counsels of princes. The counsel of the Lord shall endure forever, and the thoughts of his heart from generation to generation. Blessed is the nation whose God is the Lord, and blessed are the people he has chosen for himself to be his inheritance. The Lord looks down from heaven and beholds all the children of men from the habitation of his dwelling. He considers all those who dwell on the earth. He fashions all the hearts of them and understands all their works. There is no king who can be saved by a mighty host, neither is any mighty man delivered by great strength. A horse is considered a vain hope to save a man, neither shall it deliver anyone by its great strength. Behold, the eye of the Lord is upon those who fear him, and upon those who put their trust in his mercy, to deliver their soul from death, and to feed them in the time of famine. Our soul has patiently waited for the Lord, for he is our hope and our shield. Our heart shall rejoice in him, because we have hoped in his holy one. Let your merciful kindness, O Lord, be upon us, as we have put our trust in you. I will always give thanks unto the Lord. His praise shall ever be in my mouth. My soul shall make its boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear this and be glad. O praise the Lord with me, and let us magnify his name together. I sought the Lord, and he heard me. He delivered me out of all my fears. They looked unto him and were made glad, and their faces were not ashamed. Look, the poor man cries, and the Lord hears him, and saves him out of all his troubles. The angel of the Lord comes round about those who fear him, and delivers them in time of need. Oh, taste and see how gracious the Lord is. Blessed is the one who trusts in him. Oh, fear the Lord, you that are his saints. For those who fear him lack nothing. The lions lack and suffer hunger. But those who seek the Lord shall lack nothing that is good. Come, children, and listen to me. I will teach you the fear of the Lord. Who among you desires to live and longs to see good days? Keep your tongue from evil and your lips from speaking lies. Turn from evil into good. Seek peace and pursue it. The eyes of the Lord are upon the righteous, and his ears are open to their prayers. The countenance of the Lord is against those who do evil, to root out the remembrance of them from the earth. The righteous cry, and the Lord hears them and delivers them out of all their troubles. The Lord is near to those who are brokenhearted, and will save those who are crushed in spirit. Great are the troubles of the righteous, but the Lord delivers him out of them all. He keeps all his bones so that not one of them is broken. But evil shall slay the ungodly, and those who hate the righteous shall be desolate. The Lord delivers the souls of his servants, and all those who put their trust in him shall not be destitute. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the book of Job, beginning with the fourth chapter, the first verse. Then Eliphaz the Temanite responded, "If one ventures a word with you, will you become impatient? But who can refrain from speaking? Behold, you have taught many, and you have strengthened weak hands. Your words have helped the stumbling to stand, and you have strengthened feeble knees. But now it comes to you, and you are impatient. It touches you, and you are horrified. Is your fear of God not your confidence, and the integrity of your ways your hope? Remember now, whoever perished, being innocent, or where were the upright destroyed? According to what I have seen, those who plow wrongdoing and those who sow trouble harvested, by the breath of God they perish, and by the blast of his anger they come to an end. The roaring of the lion and the voice of the fiercer lion and the teeth of the young lions are broken out. The lion perishes for lack of prey, and the cubs of the lioness are scattered. Now a word was brought to me secretly, and my ear received a whisper of it amid disquieting thoughts from visions of the night when deep sleep falls on people. Dread came upon me in trembling and made all my bones shake. Then a spirit passed by my face, the hair of my flesh stood up. Something was standing still, but I could not recognize its appearance. A form was before my eyes. There was silence. Then I heard a voice, "Can mankind be righteous before God? Can a man be pure before his maker? He puts no trust even in his servants, and he accuses his angels of error. How much more those who live in houses of clay, whose foundation is in the dust, who are crushed before the moth. Between morning and evening, they are broken in pieces. Unregarded, they perish forever. Is their tent cord not pulled out within them? They die yet without wisdom." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Surely it is God who saves me. I will trust in him and not be afraid. For the Lord is my stronghold and my sure defense, and he will be my savior. Therefore you shall draw water with rejoicing from the springs of salvation. And on that day you shall say, "Give thanks to the Lord," and call upon his name. Make his deeds known among the people. See that they remember that his name is exalted. Sing the praises of the Lord, for he has done great things, and this is known in all the world. Cry aloud, inhabitants of Zion. Ring out your joy, for the Great One in the midst of you is the Holy One of Israel. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from St. Paul's Epistle to St. Titus, beginning with the third chapter of the first verse. Remind them to be subject to rulers, to authorities, to be obedient, and to be ready for every good deed, to slander no one, not to be contentious, to be gentle, showing every consideration for all people. For we too were once foolish, disobedient, deceived, enslaved to various lusts and pleasures, spending our life in malice and envy, hateful, hating one another. But when the kindness of God, our Savior, and his love for mankind appeared, he saved us, not on the basis of deeds which we did in righteousness, but in accordance with his mercy, by the washing of regeneration and renewing by the Holy Spirit, whom he richly poured out upon us through Jesus Christ, our Savior, so that being justified by his grace, we would be made heirs according to the hope of eternal life. This statement is trustworthy. And concerning these things, I want you to speak confidently, so that those who have believed God will be careful to engage in good deeds. These things are good and beneficial for people. But avoid foolish controversies and genealogies and strife and disputes about the law, for they are useless and worthless. Reject a divisive person after a first and second warning, knowing that such a person has deviated from what is right and is sinning, being self-condemned. When I send Artemas or Archicus or Tychicus to you, make every effort to come to me at Nicopolis, for I have decided to spend the winter there. Diligently help Zenas, the lawyer, and Apollos on their way so that nothing is lacking for them. Our people must also learn to engage in good deeds to meet pressing needs so that they will not be unproductive. All who are with me greet you. Greet those who love us in the faith. Grace be with you all. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has regarded the lowliness of his handmaiden. But behold, from now on all generations will call me blessed. For he that is mighty has magnified me, and holy is his name, and his mercy is on those who fear him throughout all generations. He has shown the strength of his arm, scattered the proud in the imagination of their hearts. He has brought down the mighty from their thrones, and has exalted the humble and meek. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent empty away. He, remembering his mercy, has helped his servant Israel, as he promised to our fathers, Abraham, and his seed forever. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you, and with your spirit. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. That this evening may be holy, good, and peaceful, we entreat you, O Lord. That your holy angels may lead us in paths of peace and goodwill, we entreat you, O Lord. That we may be pardoned and forgiven for our sins and offenses, we entreat you, O Lord. That there may be peace in your church and in the whole world, we entreat you, O Lord. That we may depart this life in your faith and fear, and not be condemned before the great judgment seat of Christ, we entreat you, O Lord. Almighty and everlasting God, who in the Paschal mystery established a new covenant of reconciliation, grant that all who have been reborn into the fellowship of Christ's body may show forth in their lives what they profess by their faith, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. O God, the source of eternal light, shed forth your unending day upon us. who watch for you, that our lips may praise you, our lives may bless you, and our worship on the morrow give you glory through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Keep watch, dear Lord, with those who work or watch or weep this night, and give your angels charge over those who sleep. Tend the sick, Lord Christ, give rest to the weary, bless the dying, soothe the suffering, pity the afflicted, shield joyous, and all for your love's sake. Amen. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all, for your immeasurable love in the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies, that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service, and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit, in honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications to you, and you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will grant their requests. Fulfill now, Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Alleluia, alleluia. Let us bless the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia. Thanks be to God. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen.